set to bring you today's action. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Glad you're here with us tonight for this Monday night presentation. And tonight, it'll be the Charlotte Hornets going up against the Atlanta Hawks at State Farm Arena. Hello, everyone. With Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, I'm Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from our Hall of Famer on the sideline, David Aldridge. And taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Danilo Gallinari.
And looking at his offensive numbers from the past few years, it seems like teams around the league have kind of figured him out. He's having to work a lot harder for his points, and he hasn't been coming nearly as easily as they used to be.
And as things get ready to roll, let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's on the sideline. David?
Kevin, thank you. Gordon Hayward is a versatile offensive player, but he said, for me, being aggressive is playing downhill. Usually, if I can get things going to the rim first, it opens up every other part of my game. And he's still able to collapse defenses, finish, and create for teammates. Guys?
David, he is the total package. Yeah, tonight, Greg, two teams with a lot of talent, but also a lot of inexperience.
And we'll see some spectacular plays, but also a few boneheaded ones as well. Always interesting to watch these young players develop.
So let's take a look at the Charlotte starting lineup. Up in the forward spots is Hayward and Bridges. The guard spots are filled by Ball and Rozier. And it's Plumlee in at the pivot, manning the middle. For the Hawks, at the guard positions, Young and Herter. Collins and Capella make up the inside pair. And it's Hunter in at the small forward position. Rozier kicks the ball. That's good, and it's Rozier with the assist. Ball's got the first points up on the board here for the Hornets. And the call will be against LaMelo Ball. That is his first foul of the game.
Foul right off the bat. You hate to pick up your first one so quick.
Young against Ball. Rozier with the steal. And now the fast break. Bridges with the ball. Oh, he blocked it in the front off the backboard. And again, Charlotte with the triple.
But what a clean shot for Rozier. You hear this squad work hard to create those.
And every year, Terry Rozier seems to get better. Specifically, Greg, becoming more efficient at the score.
I mean, he's improving his percentages over the years, especially his three-point shooting. When he came into the league, was not a threat from deep. Now, you have got to honor that outside shot.
Good on the triple.
Right back at you. You knew Hayward didn't like being scored on. He hits it from the end zone.
Here's Young. Ball with the block. Plumlee with it. Guarded by Hunter. On pass from Plumlee. Rozier gets the ball. Carries it from three-point range. Ball's got 6 points.
Oh, great ball movement there.
It's a 9-point spread. Young is double. Bob pass to Capella, and the dunk by Capella.
And sometimes all you got to do is allow him to come his way. Often he takes care of the rest.
Hayward dishes to Plumlee. Rozier for three. That hit that one. So Plumlee taking the other one. Coming into this, having us to win against the Rockets in their last game.
Remarkable consistency for me. You can't count on that every game, especially on the road. They were connecting. When they're connecting like that, they're hard to beat. Their accuracy from outside, just incredible.
And a chance there to look back at the stunning Mobile One block a moment ago.
And right out of the gate, trying to set the tone defensively, you gotta love that energy.
Young with the ball. Here's coming off a 28-point game against Houston. Here's Capella, and a dunk by Capella.
You know what really separates Detroit is his explosiveness around the rim. My goodness.
Here's Ball. Rozier looking around from deep three-point range. And again, the Hornets miss him. For Atlanta, they've gone 3 or 5 in the ball so far. Here's Herter.
starting in the 2020 All-Star game, Trae Young had an incredible night, dropping 50 points against the Miami Heat.
And Young became the fourth youngest NBA player to get to 50. Only Devin Booker, LeBron, and Brandon Jennings got to 50 in a game at a younger age. Perhaps the most impressive part of Trae's performance, he did it against coach Eric Spoelstra's Miami, one of the top defensive teams in the league. And another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball effectively here so far. And he just dangles from the bucket after sending that one through.
And you can see which team has the swagger right now. Here's Young. Charlotte. After the basket by Charlotte. And the call will be against Lamelo Ball. That'll be his second foul of the game. Bogdan and Chiefs checked in for the Hawks. The Hornets also with the sub. Washington's checked in for Plumlee.
Thank you. Lakers fans, you got to take the long-term perspective deciding when to return.
There's certain times where it's not our decision to not play. There are certain times where guys want to play, and the coaching staff and the training staff feels like it's in the team's best interest to not play. You know, there's certain injuries you really can't play with.
Great teams are more sophisticated than ever when it comes to injury prevention.
And training staffs are now expected to anticipate risk. So at times, they'll know before the player does that there's a concern.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. Looking at what we've seen from the Warriors, what do you think?
Just a terrific first quarter, sparked really by their unselfishness.
Oh, yeah. Love the ball movement so far. Everything clicking at the offensive end.
And Charlotte, look at who they picked. We've got Montrezl Harrell. Hayward out there with Washington. And it's Ball. And it's a point guard.
Man, wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
But look at the basket guy still shaking. Ball, no good. Hawks trail by eight.
And with the ball, it is still struck. Oh, exactly what the Hawks need. Great production and a face of the franchise type of talent.
Oubre against Bogdanovich. Rebound by the Hawks. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. All around here wide open. That ball. Nice. Big time for Bogdanovich. Oh, no, he's got 5 points in the quarter.
Some high IQ basketball from Bogdanovich. Moves the ball to the wide open man for an assist.
You know, great thinking about LaMelo and this team. He's got the fans here in Charlotte excited.
Man, Kevin, let's be honest here for a moment. The Hornets haven't had a lot of luck in the draft. Finally, they knocked one out of the park, and the fans are ecstatic.
And Zoic Yalu brings it up for Atlanta. A 6-point game. Last time they came together was in Charlotte, where they fell to the Hornets.
And their last time playing as well. Foul trouble became a big problem for them. The starters had to take an early stint on the bench.
Yeah, and they can't afford a repeat of that. They need a lot more minutes out of the Hornets.
And another shot. Does not find the mark. He's made two and missed one now. Hornets lead by six. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, the Atlanta Hawks are back. Last season, they won the Southeast Division for the first time in six seasons. With quality players in every position, things are starting to gel. Trae Young said, "This feels good. We just have a lot of belief in each other. Guys, they are poised to be good for a long time."
Well, they've clearly made the turn, David. Thanks. And it's Oubre off the drive, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Oubre's got the lead up to 10 now for the Hornets.
And creating a little separation here, gaining some confidence.
Yeah, just one step in there right now. Looking to build off the advantage even further.
Now Atlanta making a switch here. Williams is checked in. On defense, the Hornets. 10-point lead. This is their biggest. The Hornets have gone 4-6 in the field here in the second. On its way from Hayward for two. Laying soft on the front of Brandon Fox. Hayward's got 11 points.
This is where Hayward just gets better and better. Squaring up off the catch.
And the foul is called on P.J. Washington. That's his first foul. Some changes for Charlotte. Miles Bridges comes in for Montrezl Harrell. And Terry Rozier subbed in for Oubre. 3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. Young taking his time. And block. That one goes careening off the glass.
Oh, nice defense from Bridges. When he hustles like this, he's capable of swatting shots.
And there's Okongwu. That's good. That's just Okongwu. Okongwu's now got his first 2 points. Ball, the bounce pass. Three-pointer, Hayward. In recent teams around the league trying to integrate star veterans with talented rookies. Greg, it's not always easy, is it?
Not at all, Kevin. And a lot of times it becomes a choice between win now or win later. Though the teams with great coaching from outside. He's got five.
You know, spacing the floor is so important in today's NBA. So Bridges, three-point ability, it fits right there.
Bogdanovich goes in. Basket is good on the assist for Williams. 6 points for Bogdanovich. And here's Charlotte. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Passes it to Hayward. Fires from deep. And it's the Hornets, another three.
Yeah, that's two bombs in a row from long range.
Here's Young. He has seven. The pass to O'Connell. Daniel Poole.
That's a major lead breakdown.
It's a tight grip on that rim, too, after the finish. Ball, the pass to Hayward. And here is Rozier. He's guarded by Williams. Rozier kicks the ball. And another three for Charlotte.
And this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
But when he's hitting from range on a consistent basis, it makes everything easier.
Oh, and it's sent big by Washington.
A great instinct there for Washington. The situation is up to spike.
Yeah, coach's pet peeve there. No box out.
Oh, that is simple. You fail to put a body on someone, you're inviting a breakdown with defensive legs.
Allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim. No wonder you're losing.
Yeah. Horrible effort. It appears they may be on the brink.
Young's shot is off. He got it up. He doesn't hit that one. LaMelo Ball getting it done for the Hornets. He's been a major threat from three-point range. Got two of them to fall in that quarter. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. With Hornets head coach James Borrego. Coach, what are you getting from LaMelo Ball in the first half?
Great job, you know, getting us into our sets. Defensively, he's been great. Offensively, getting us into a rhythm, pushing the pace, but we don't have something getting us into our offense.
He's done it all so far, coach. Thanks for your time. Back to you.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and let's talk the first half. Big time play throughout the first half for LaMelo Ball. He ended up with 17 points, 2 rebounds, and 8 assists. He didn't perform up to his standards in their last game. Tonight's a different story. He obviously has a short memory. Kenny, your thoughts on the Hornets' first half?
It all starts with their defense, and they're on fire from behind the arc. And I can say the opposite when it comes to the other side. When there's this much disparity in three-point shooting, it usually makes a big difference on the floor.
And over to the big fella, your thoughts on the Hawks?
They're getting abused in the paint defensively. Their opponents set the tone. Can't match up physically, you're toast. That's what the scoreboard is reflecting right now. Toast with butter.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
Tighten up here in the second. And get at the forward positions, Hunter and Collin. At the guard positions, Young and Herder. And it's Capella in the center. So that's the lineup.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Here's Rozier. And that one is hammered home.
So explosive on his way to the rim. Rozier is skilled at knifing inside and hurting.
Hawks trail by 15.
dug outside. Trying to get the cover to Douglas. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
I'm sure his teammates love having a guy like Collins on the receiving end of those alley-oops. As fun an assist as you'll get. Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury. He
rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
Pass to Young. Here's Capella over Plumlee. That one wide left. Here's Bridges. And slammed in by Bridges.
Oh, incredible verticality from Bridges. I mean, he takes off over the defense and just buries the dunk.
And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. You know, Greg, sometimes it's just hard to quantify defense, but some new age metrics really value this approach.
There's a stat called defensive box plus minus that measures how good your team is with you on the floor. Right? Year in, year out, Mason Plumlee is top 20 in the league, proving his overall effect on the defensive end.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thank you, guys. We have seen today's athletes take their stands for social justice. That's what Bradley Beal says. We understand there will be a backlash, but we don't care about that. You would be a citizen, just like everybody else. Have family and friends still living in those environments.
Checked in for Young. And a switcher also for Charlotte. Oubre is checked in. And it's Wright with the ball for the Hawks. Trailing by 17. Outside Collins. To the paint. Here's Capella. And the dunk by Capella. The pass to Plumlee for three. Oubre sinks the three-pointer.
Oubre Jr.
Oubre has got his third basket of the night right there.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Hunter, and he banks it away.
With the number of moves and shots to choose from, Hunter is scary. Nice bucket there.
Ball against Wright. Rebound, Atlanta. Capella's got four rebounds in this game. The Hawks trail by 16. Hunter, no one around him.
A very consistent three-point shooter. Hunter shoots it well from there because of how confident he is.
Ball, the bounce pass. Rozier for three. And it's the Hornets, another three.
Some players might wear down during this kind of run. He's only
Atlanta has gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Driving inside.
Yeah, watch Rozier take over. I mean, he has so many tricks and fun shots up his sleeve.
Atlanta's gone to 3-1 range 7 times tonight, knocked down 5 of them. Right, the pass to Herter. And they immediately answer back at the dunk at the other end.
I tell you, he's playing the game with pure excitement right now.
He kept off that dunk with some serious hang time on the rim. Oubre can't get it to go. For Atlanta, they've gone 8-10 shooting here on the second half. Very strong. And then bucket in no time at all. Hunter's got 5 points now this quarter.
And how about the awareness Hunter possesses? Understands that one of his guys has an opportunity.
Pass to Oubre. And it's the Hornets, another three.
Oubre Jr.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor. These days, so much emphasis on the perimeter game. You can see why after that sequence.
Back to Collins. Hawks passing it around. They get it back. They'll put that, and it's put back up and in. But Capella.
The shooting has really been there for him today, but he may have to take it upon himself to continue to carry this team and try and get out of this hole.
The kick out to Ball. Pass to Oubre for three. Rebounded by the Hawks. Capella's got rebound number 8 now on the night. The Hawks trail by 14. In the corner is Hunter. Driving in. And it's Hunter with the jam.
And what I admire about Hunter is that opportunistic attitude. This kid just makes
things happen.
4-3, Oubre. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. Oubre, who's got 13.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
3-pointer. Off the mark. Big-time effort for Jerry Rozier, providing a lot of energy for Charlotte. He totaled 14 points in the quarter. He's given them all the offense they need right now. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
Shots today, and that was the right move. He's been a huge weapon for them, and you
We've always heard of guys being in a zone shooting, but you can be in a zone passing the basketball, and we've seen that tonight as well.
Here's what Atlanta's going with right now. John Collins, he's checked in for O'Connor. And it's DeAndre Hunter in for Gallinari.
Accepting more responsibility over time. By Donovan, you've got to love his willingness to take these shots.
And the Hornets call time here.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
Without question. They're giving up too many high percentage looks. A trend that they'd like to fucking
away from. A moment to present the New Balance player of the game, Terry Rozier.
Hey, guys, no doubt who our pick was going to be. He's made everyone else on the court look like they're playing at half speed. It's been total domination, and you can't help but just sit back and admire that performance.
Bridges is checked in for Washington. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hi, guys. I was able to catch the message James Borrego gave to his team. He said, I love how we're shooting basketball. You guys have been locked in from three. Just keep taking makeable shots. If you don't have it, pass it to the guy who does. Kevin?
Yes, he does have range. The confidence to touch it. Shoot from anywhere.
Atlanta calls timeout. Ice game. Great performance by Terry Rozier.
They got to start guarding him out to about 2 feet because he's killing from long range.
And here's Young. He'll bring it up for Atlanta. 7-point differential. And that one is good.
In the game.
Atlanta's gotten the groove from 3-point range here. 4-for-4 since the third quarter ended. Now the ball's going. And a very elite jam.
And pressure doesn't get to Collins. The baskets like that prove how locked in he is.
He does all the good. He's the best. He's got them in front with another outstanding performance.
Left in the fourth. Young, good look. Pulled the shot a little under, and the bounce hurts his leg. Young's got 9 points now, just the second half. Here's Ball. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's a 4-point foul. Take it.
Switch here. Herder's checked in.
Perfectly done at the stripe there. That brings their lead up to an even more comfortable run.
Stolen away. Pass
break here. Here come the Hawks. Herter, no good. Now, here's Bridges. And so it's Charlotte with the win. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Gordon, a great win over a very explosive team tonight.
Yeah, they're a team, you got to be physical with them. You know, you can't let them get a rhythm going with the scores and the talent that they have. So we had to really match their intensity, and I thought it was a great one.
I know that's what you guys work on extensively in the show tonight. Thanks, Gordon. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Chris Weber, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. See you later.